dann. Episode 7. And because we captured the pack this time on the end of the chapter, we need to actually go and get him revived. So for that we are going to have to, or rather he stays dead in that case. We're going to give this guy a lizard tail, we are going to give him the Dark Rosary and the Devil Belt. We can leave this guy with the Cat's Claw. We can give him the Devil's Ring and the Feather Token. And we can just start the next stage. So, at this stage, we want to set up certain patterns. So we throw this guy up there, we take this guy and do a diagonal throw into this guy. Now just simply use the camaraderie to hit all three of them, go to the base, take a demon's breath onto these guys, do a mystic blast onto these three, use the demon's breath onto these three, and afterwards you take Lahal and Overlord's Wrath these three as well, because they won't die at one, so they won't be one shot. And that's something that was unfortunate, and you can immediately start this next stage. That's no issue. This time you want to throw them into each other in this way. You want to take the two on the far ends to be capable of finishing this basically by just two attacks more. You have to take this guy, lift him up, because otherwise you can't walk through him. Now everything is set up. Just use the camaraderie on these guys and another camaraderie on these three and execute, and that should take care of everything and end that stage. I think it's possible, yeah, possible to skip another heal. And now you have to take the 170 pack up here, lift him, and you need to use the Nekomata. And now you need to double throw her downwards and regular attack this panel, because otherwise you can't pass this green area. Now you want to diagonal throw from down, so you go to the max range and press left in this direction with the camera, and just camaraderie these two guys. Now this is not what would have happened. Usually this guy would be walking upwards up here and would end up here, but because it didn't, I need to do this, unfortunately, so I need to get another one to throw out. Now I throw this guy here, and then here. I'll use another proxy so I can't miss the diagonal throw, because I don't want to mess it up, and cause an extra round. So here it's possible to use pills and just finish off these three and it's done. This time we need to heal. Otherwise, there's not enough SP for finishing the next stage, basically. So here, you ignore this pack and set everything else up in a counterclockwise positioning, starting with the highest level on the upper position, then left, then right, left, down, right. So you get this pattern here. Now you can take the highest level out, just camaraderie once on these guys to finish everything off. Then I'm going to use the Trompo combo on this guy, use the Nekomata's Mystic Blast on these two, use the Puck's Demon's Breath for these two, and I'm going to attack these guys with the jackpot from the pumpkins. So now I have perfect placement for these two final zombies, and I just need to come over three and finished. We can just immediately start the next area, and here we again manipulate the AI by doing these simple things. We have to put Edna on this space. The highest level puck is going to attack up there. The Necromata goes here, and the second puck is going here. Afterwards, we can enter our turn. Now, because they can't reach Edna from the bottom, they will all move to Edna in this way, and you can simply pick this guy up, throw him here, and camaraderie up there, and that will take care of most of the enemies. So now what will happen is, yeah, these last two zombies, which didn't move previously, are going to start to move, and unfortunately my Nekomata can't reach that guy with the skills, so I'm going to auto attack him. And finished. That concludes this episode.